This is a small lake measuring 120 meters wide in the absolute middle of nowhere in remote North America. However, this lake is special. Not only does it contain an even smaller island inside it, but this lake in of itself is located on an island. And that larger island is located within a lake which itself is located on an even larger island, which is then all located within an even larger lake. This represents the world's first discovered fifth-order island, which is more than 200 kilometers away from the closest populated settlement, with that being Baker Lake. The largest lake in this recursive feature is known as Yathkyed Lake, which comprises an area of 1,449 square kilometers in Canada's Nunavut territory. Looking around, you can spot so many other lakes, too numerous to count in fact, marking a portion of Canada's more than 2 million estimated lakes. With such an absurdly high number of lakes, it is not a surprise that a fifth-order lake exists. In other words, by sheer chance, random variation in the formation of these lakes allowed this unnamed lake to form. However, this is the simple answer, as the reason why all of these lakes formed, including the aforementioned Fifth Order Lake, relates to Canada's geologic history. If we zoom out and look at a map of Canada from satellite, we can see that the nation geographically is divided into three subregions based on their appearance and ruggedness. To the far west, we have a series of four large mountain ranges marking large patches of rugged terrain that include the Cascade Range, Rocky Mountains, Coast Mountains, and Mackenzie Mountains. To the east is a fairly flat piece of terrain with a moderate density of lakes known as the Interior Plains. Yet, once the terrain even further east starts to become completely filled with tightly clustered lakes spaced not too far apart from each other, you have reached what is known as the Canadian Shield. You can see, for example, that all four of Canada's lesser-known Great Lakes, such as Great Bear Lake, are located at the western edge of this geographic and geologic province. So, what makes the Canadian Shield so special? Put simply, the Canadian Shield is a massive craton, meaning the area outlined on screen has almost universally old rock dating back more than 1.5 billion years ago, and has not experienced a high degree of volcanism since the region formed. In other words, while other sections of the continent have experienced dramatic geologic changes during the last 1.5 billion years, this region has remained relatively intact, albeit with erosion still occurring. In fact, this area even contains the two oldest distinct rock units on Earth, dating back 4 billion years ago. This is how stable much of it has remained, despite the fact that the craton contains a number of different rock units. Almost all of the lakes contained within this craton formed during the last 2.58 million years during the Pleistocene or Holocene epochs. Repeated glaciations, which in some areas are more than 3 kilometers thick, covered almost the entirety of Canada at its peak, with the movement of these features forever changing the landscape. They left numerous lakes through three methods. 1. Scouring the landscape, creating numerous long and thin low points in the ground, which became lakes that paralleled the motion of advance the regional ice sheets had. 2. Leaving behind uneven amounts of sediment as glaciers retreated, creating many high and low points, the latter of which filled with water and thus became lakes. 3. Chunks of ice between the size of a small boulder and 8 kilometers wide, breaking off and being buried by sediment, eventually melting to form what is known as a kettle lake. All three of these lake types can be found in the vicinity of Yathkyed Lake. But what about its geology? The entirety of the islands within the lake and 99% of the rocks immediately on the rim of Yathkyed Lake are a type of rock that I jokingly call the end result of every single rock type in a craton if it doesn't get completely melted down. Gneiss. And this gneiss is dated to 2.6 billion years ago during the Neo-Archean period. Gneiss is the highest grade of metamorphic rock you can reach without partially or completely melting a rock. Thanks for watching this video. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Yarma Narnar for supporting my work.